Are you on your course page? Either on LMS training or Smart UMS? Scroll down to the course administration. No need of turning on. For creating question bank categories, editing controls are not required. In the administration block, just scroll down to question bank. You just expand this question bank. Click on categories. Done? Yes. Now, this is default is, this is parent category is your course title. Now, what we'll create is here, module wise would you like to create or week wise or chapter wise, unit wise, it's up to you. So, give if you are following module, give module 1. If you are following week, week 1. If you want to administer quiz in week 3, not in week 1, then week 3. Okay. Now, general, either we prefer module, start with module, then you can write the title. Which one would be clear? Okay then. Okay. No need of category info, it's an optional. Done. Give a name to the first category and click on add category. Similar way you do, create, yeah. Create two more categories. If you are following weekly structure, you can give week 1, week 5 or something. If you are following someone, I think is following chapter, then you can give chapter 1 so that we can import chapter 1 questions into that and randomly pick up questions. Okay. So, while giving the name, you use either your module titles or chapter titles or unit titles or week. Anything. If you want to edit this for anything, you have gear icon, you know, you can, if you want to rename it, just use this gear icon and rename. Just create three categories. That's it. Again, in those three categories, we'll create subcategories. Okay. Are you ready with three? Still you are doing. No need of category info. No need of category info. Just give a name and click on add category. That's it. Again, second one, you again give a name and create category. That's it. See, here you, if you follow the screen, just to look at this screen, like this. So, next category, right here. Next category, we'd like to create. What is the difference? Okay, this is the next category. Yeah. Okay. Biotechnology. We'll remove that. Yes, I think typo is there. Click on add category. Yeah. Now you go to this gear icon and remove all this extra information. This is only about the category info, not all the next. Edit. Not that. The first one, yes. No, don't delete this one. Yes. Hare. What did you do? Click on the gear icon. Wherever you want to edit the gear icon. Yes. Remove this. We don't want this. Remove these two. We don't want this. Is only the category. Remove. This is direct. This cannot be taken. Save changes. And what about the second category? Is it correct? Both are with that na. Second one also, by just leave it. Yes. Control C. Control V. Delete. Save changes. Okay, now you have, this is your parent course, under this you have category. Similar way, if you want to create, you can, parent category should always be this only, this one. Under this you can create. Again, now what we are going to do is, under this we will create MCQ and essay questions. For that, first you should choose your parent category, then we can create. First follow us on the screen, then you can create. Okay, now under these subcategories, we are going to add sub-subcategory. So, for that what you need to do is, from this parent category, you pull it down and pick up the category you have created. Under this, how would you like to classify your questions? Some may prefer MCQs, essay questions like that, or some may prefer easy questions, moderate or difficult. Yes. Then MCQ. Okay, click on add category. Again, we will create one more category under this. Now, pull down this parent category and pick up the category introduction. Which one? This one? No, no. Under this only, we will create one more category, essay. Yeah. Anything, but we are importing only essay and MCQs for this workshop. Later, you can import. I have another format. If time permits, you can use a GIFT format for importing true or false, matching, all these also. But and create one more category, MCQ, here. You pull down your category and essay. And click on add category. Like this, you can add any subcategories. Before importing questions, we should do this. Please remember, before importing questions, we should be ready with categories and subcategories.